Hello friends, today we are starting Photoshop Masterclass for novice to expert or for beginners to professional so that you can learn and start earning in fields of designing and editing. You can also start career as album designer, manipulator, editor, and many more. So, without wasting time, let's start Photoshop Masterclass. But before we start, we need to know Photoshop history or its versions. There are mainly two versions popular, number 1, Photoshop CS6 and number 2, Photoshop CC 2020. But what is CS and CC mean? It means, Creative Suite and Creative Cloud. Adobe started cloud storage from 2014 and renamed all platforms to CC, which were previously CS, so you can use any version, but try getting CS6 and later versions as they are similar to our working, as we are going to use Photoshop CC 2020 for these tutorials. So, when we start Photoshop, the first screen we see is the home screen, but it is seen only in latest versions from Photoshop CC 2017 till today. On this screen we see recent works or last edited photos. It also shows Lightroom photos. Lightroom is another app of Adobe for mainly color correcting. Cloud Documents shows Adobe Cloud Storage photos, which we have added to our Adobe Cloud Storage. It helps when we work anywhere by just log into Adobe account. For Adobe account and cloud, you need active subscription. And lastly Deleted, which shows deleted items. Below that we see Create New to create new document or blank page, and Open to work with existing files or previously edited documents, or to open image. As we are starting first time, let's open an image. So now our image has opened up and screen has become more complicated. But that's not the case. If we look carefully, there is top menu bar, as every software has, but few menus are new and different as they purely belong to Photoshop, so we will see all later. Next, on left we see tools, and all editing work is mainly dependent on those tools, so we will start working with tools from next chapters. Moving to right we see panels, which are interchangeable. If someone needs to add, he can add from Windows, and if he wants to reduce, he can close it by clicking three dots on every panel, or to move just drag them and place wherever needed. If we click on any tool, you can see there is change in option, which are found below the menu bar. So, today we have understood some things about Photoshop and can start working with Photoshop, right? It looks hard, but when we start working then Photoshop becomes more interesting and easier to use. Okay then. We will meet in next chapter with Photoshop's first tool known as Move Tool. And now it's me, Bhavin Palja, saying you goodbye and meet you soon. Till that time, like, comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe.